Number four on the list is SummerSlam 2002. Honestly, in my opinion, that this one has the biggest main event almost, I think, in SummerSlam history. You have The Rock versus Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar going after his first WWF championship. Of course, this is the undisputed belt at the time. The Rock was sort of sliding into that progression where he was going to be leaving sooner than later, and he was going to be chasing that dream of becoming, you know, Hollywood's biggest movie star. At this time, it wasn't 100% clear that The Rock was going to be as big of a star as he is now, but he definitely was doing it with movies like The Mummy. That was the first one that came out. The Scorpion King is what that was, and of course from there he slid into a few other movie roles. The one with Sean William Scott comes to mind, but if you watch his older movies, you can tell The Rock's a star, but I don't think many people knew that he was going to become the star that he is today. From there, you also move into the non-sanctioned Shawn Michaels versus Triple H match, the feud of the former DX partners. That honestly is a really, really good battle. It's an unsanctioned street fight. Basically, Eric Bischoff washed his hands. He said, "I know you two guys want to beat the shit out of each other, but you're not going to do it where, you know, the WWF or Monday Night Raw is going to be held liable for any injuries." This, of course, is Shawn Michaels' return to wrestling after a long absence, after he hurt his back, of course, in the casket match with The Undertaker and wrestling that last match against Stone Cold Steve Austin at WrestleMania. Great match, Chris Benoit and Rob Van Dam fighting over the Intercontinental Championship. You also get another really good match between Edge and Eddie Guerrero. One of my favorite Kurt Angle matches is going to be on here, Kurt Angle versus Rey Mysterio. Number four on the list, SummerSlam 2002, a definite keeper, should be in everyone's collection.